Southport Baptist Church, an American Baptist church located at the corner of Banta and McFarland Road in Southport, Indiana. Sunday morning service is offered every morning at 9:30, and we invite everyone to join us. Today we have a special service featuring the New Heritage Trio. Now please enjoy today's presentation.
It is my pleasure to introduce to you New Heritage. I've known each of these guys for some time. They're all three great guys. And is that the way you said to say it? Okay, all right. I've had the opportunity to meet these guys' pastor, and it is a blessing always to hear good music. And you're going to hear some of that today. I'm guessing you guys are going to introduce yourselves. Okay, great. So without any further ado, let's give a nice round of applause to
just a Lord, that's worship time with us. We do not take that lightly. We hope you're having a good time so far. Are you having a good time so far? And, next 3 hours are going to be great, so just settle in. We're good. We want to take just a second to introduce the guys to you. This iteration of the group has been together for about a year now. I came on board with the group about a year ago, and Dave and Brian have been seeing together for quite a while. I've known them for many years, and what Pastor Jeff said was very true. These are two of the finest Christian men that I've ever met in my life, and it's a pleasure to stand on stage with them every time we get up and share the gospel through song. Let me introduce them for you real quick. The young man singing tenor is highly talented, a great Christian young man. He is a light in some very dark places that he goes to, and he's the young one of the group. He's the baby. He sings the ladies' part. You don't know how difficult it is to find a guy that looks like a man and sings like a woman. But we found him, so we sort of hung on to him. But he does a great job. From Evansville, Indiana, Mr. Brian Castellano. Gentlemen, sing the lead part. You just heard him featured on that last song. Dave does all of our recording in his basement. It's not as nefarious as it sounds, but it's a legitimate thing. We do all of our recording, all of our practicing at Dave's house in the basement. When I auditioned for the group, Dave sent me a text and said, come to my house, here's the address, and come to the basement. He said, just come on in, the door will be open, and we'll be in the basement. So I told my family, I said, this is where I'm going. If I'm not back in an hour, send the police to this address. This guy wants me to come to the basement. I'm not really sure what I'm walking into. But turned out pretty well. Dave Lodgewell is one of the finest men I've ever met in my life. He is a true man of God and a great witness, and he does a fantastic job singing lead for New Heritage. So do make him welcome, please, from Evansville, Mr. Dave Lodgewell. My name is David Ford. I sing what's left. They start singing, and I just sort of fill in the gaps. But it's a pleasure to be here this morning again. Thank you so much for opening your doors and sharing your Sunday morning service with us. Pastor Jeff, we appreciate the invitation. And anytime you want us to come back, we'd be glad to, as long as it's higher than 40 degrees outside. So, that being said, I'm going to stop talking. We're going to start singing some more.
Christian. everything I need.
This is why we don't let him talk very much.
The name New Heritage comes from several different places. One of them being the type of music that we sing just naturally honors the heritage of the church. The music that we sing, the songs that we choose to sing, we constantly try to keep that at the forefront of our minds. That what we do has a very specific purpose. We are called a Southern Gospel Trio for a reason. We sing Southern music that shares the gospel of Jesus Christ. So part of the heritage of the church fits right in with what we do every time we stand on stage. But that's why you'll hear us sing songs like Mansion Over the Hilltop and songs like the one we're getting ready to do that you've probably heard 100 times in your life as a Christian. But the message is ever new, and it's always true. That no matter what happens in your life, it's always good to seek a closer walk with God. That's what this old song talks about. But listen to this.
Amazing grace. will always be my song of praise, for it was grace that bought my liberty. I do not know just why he came to love me so. He looked beyond my thoughts and saw my need.
I shall go.
Just a closer walk,
yeah.
just a glimpse of
badly for him. Half the time I look over and he's going, oh, jeez.
The scariest part was bridges.
I thought poor kid was going to have a heart attack. And of course, they brought. You know, we prayed before we went, and that's exactly what we needed. And we got here safe and sound, and we're here with you today. We're very thankful. As David said, we don't take that lightly, Pastor Jeff. We really don't. And we appreciate the opportunity to share, hopefully, something we sing, not necessarily say, but something that we sing, something touches, and maybe just brings back a memory. It's just a blessing that was just for you today. And if that's the case, then it makes it worthwhile to us. This is a song, I have no idea if any of you guys would have heard this before. I had not. And when David came to the group, he had this old song. And you know, sometimes you can't find music for these things because, you know, somebody, it was an obscure writer. It's a very rare lyric. And the particular title of this song is familiar, but the song itself isn't. And so we had the track made for us because it was that rare, it was that unusual. It just hadn't been done very much. But what a great message there is in a song like this that says, I'm at peace. I mean, he wasn't at peace yesterday, but God took care of us. The song says, I'm at peace. All is well. And David didn't give himself a proper introduction, but we were very blessed to have him. He'd been away from gospel music for a long time, been in the praise and worship band at our local church. And we were so happy that he felt the time was right for him to get back in. And we feel blessed to have someone with his talent and his desire for this type of music, his love to sing what he does and give all the glory to God. I want you to listen to David Ford, our baritone, as he sings this great old song. It says, all is well.
Thank you.
very traditional Southern gospel called Painted Land, just inside.
Moses led God's children home.
Yeah.
we've just got a few more songs to do. This next song we're going to do, and I promise this is the one that I originally checked. 2014 was a very strange year. I know for my family, sort of for all of our families. And as a group, it was a different kind of year. A lot of transition, a lot of changes. Two members of this particular group came and went in 2014. We could go around this auditorium today and probably get story after story after story of things that have gone on in your lives and our lives that have tested us to the point that you just start to question your faith. And that's not something that God is a stranger to. That's not something that, as a child of God, we should fear. It's a natural process as a human being. That in those tough times, in those hard times in our lives, we start to question, God, why are you letting this happen? But, there's the important part, but he always has a plan. 3 years ago, when my pastor stood in front of our church and said, God has a plan and I'm going away, we were stunned. We didn't know what to do. But Pastor Jeff, we've got all this stuff going on. What's happening? We questioned deeply, some of us. Some fell by the wayside. They just left. But God was true. He was faithful. Our church still stands. The word is still spoken. Lives are still reached because of our faith. Because we've held on to faith. God brought this man here to you in the time that you needed him because of your faith. So know this morning. If you hear nothing else that we say or nothing else that we sing, pay close attention to this next song. You can lose your home. You can lose your health. You could lose your job. You could lose everything. But there it is again. If you still have your faith in God and what he's done for us as his children, you will still have it all. Listen to Dave Lutch. We'll sing this fantastic new song that we just started doing, I Still Have It All.
Answer. Watch it!
enjoyed our time with you here this morning. God's making a lot of things. Tonight he's making snow. At least at home he is. I don't know about here. But we'll be heading back to Evansville in a bit. You know, and David articulated it very well. The songs we sing tend to have that little country southern edge to it, or what's traditionally come to be known as southern gospel music, as the southern part. The other part, the more important part, is the gospel part. The part that tells you that there's a Savior who lives for you and I. And how ashamed of ourselves should we be as a gospel group if we come out here purely for the purposes of entertainment and we haven't really presented the gospel? And I think that's the thread that runs through every song that we sing, the message, the more important message, sometimes embedded a little bit too deeply, but it's always there. On this last song we want to do for you, this that we would call our invitation song. It's front and center. The 23rd Psalm, so often that we think of in a sad way. It holds this great promise to us. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd. Here, Donnie Rambo, one of my favorite all-time songwriters, I wrote this song. And so many of these songs, you know, they're written, the great songs were never written because of money or fame. They were written out of tragedy and triumph. They were written out of joy, and they were written out of sadness. They were written from that place deep inside your soul that it had to come out. And maybe it helped the person who wrote it. But down through the years, like Scripture, it's inspired and it's blessed others. That's how I think about this song. If you're here today and you have that special need, whatever that might be, and maybe it might be physical, it might be financial, maybe it's spiritual, maybe you've gotten a little far away from God. You didn't mean to. Things happen, and you think he would never want me back. But I can tell you from personal experience, grace is bigger than you and I. You can't be outside God's reach. You can't be outside his loving arms. As Pastor Jeff comes forward, I want you to listen to Brian. I'll move out of the way so he can sing this song. Just a great message. Listen. Listen with your heart as he sings for you, sheltered in the arms of God.
They say, come home.